This followed a query raised in the 2021-2022 Auditor General's report, which revealed that NADS advanced 39 billion shillings to Pathways advocates to compensate tea nursery operators who had sued government for failure to procure their seedlings. But there was no evidence furnished to auditors indicating that the intended beneficiaries received the said funds.
I just want to ask Mr. Katabazi, if you will, take us through just briefly the consent judgment that you are familiar with.
City lawyer Patrick Chichoncho appeared before COSASE, which he snubbed last week, and informed Parliament that he was approached by eight people on behalf of other 711 tea nursery bed operators, led by Frank Biaruhanga, Francis Runumi, Caleb Tumwesimira, Sam Arinaitwe, Julius Tumushabe, Fidelis Kanyamunyu, and Reverend Bernard Biamugisha to represent them against a claim they had against National Agricultural Advisory Services for their unpaid claims.
The law firm demanded for the money, and the money was secured on 15th of June 2021, and a further payment of 12 billion was secured on the 17th of November, both payments totaling 39 billion. So this is a confirmation on our side that this money, 39 billion, was received.
The lawyer also admitted that his law firm has so far received 39 billion shillings, and this was sent directly to the beneficiaries, and the only pending payment to the farmers is 1.86 billion shillings, remarking,
39 billion has been sent directly to beneficiaries, forwarded to us by the plaintiffs, covering both claims, legal and administrative expenses. We have a few nursery bed operators that have been forwarded by the plaintiffs whose claims have not been 100% completed.
However, his submission that farmers are appreciative of the services rendered by the law firm were contested by Richard Muhumuza, the Bwamba County MP, who claimed to be in possession of some bank statements from some tea farmers, who raised alarm on the variation in the amount of funds submitted by Chichoncho in his accountability report to NADS and the amounts that the farmers received in their bank accounts.
The evidence we wanted as a committee in the form of bank statement is not the bank statement of the client. It's the bank statement of the law firm. When you transfer money, when you pay money from your account to the client, that money is indicated on the firm's bank statement.
The MP further tabled more evidence, claiming that Chichoncho made a second payment on 1st December 2022 to Matsiko's account, but however, some of the money was transferred back to the law firm's account. Muhumuza added that another farmer, Henry Tukahira, on 5th December 2022, received some funds on his account. However, on the same day, part of the money was debited back to the law firm's account.
According to the accountabilities submitted to NADS by Mr. Katabazi, Mr. Siraj Masiko received 150,928,485 shillings. That is according to the accountability
you submitted.
At every stage of implementing the payments, we have provided an update to NADS in the form of what we have paid.
The one here where they deposited 34 million, on that very minute, they removed 22 million. I'm requesting full chair and the honorable members who want to know where this man took our money, because we got loans to do this project.
Lucy Akelo, the vice chairperson COSASE, asked officials from NADS to clarify on the schedules of the accountability they say they received from Chichoncho after the lawyer denied that he submitted the said documents, to which Samuel Mugasi, the executive director, replied that the schedules were generated by Chichoncho's law firm.
You rightfully told us at the beginning that you cannot give us certain documents. Only and only speak to us about a document if you have furnished it with the committee.
Our records show that for the first part of these payments that we are relating to, he has received 100% payment.
Who is he again?
Is he the one who gave the statement? Masko.
Is he the one who gave the bank statement?
Yes, he's the one.
I'm disturbed with the understanding of the lawyer, because the matter that we are dealing with here is about fraud, in my view. The members are submitting, the beneficiaries, that when this man gave us this amount of money, he deducted it by half. Others are saying they were forced to put the money on the company account.
This prompted the vice chairperson, Akello, to hand over Chichoncho to Parliament Police for further investigations into the matter and ask the witness who appeared before the committee to record their statements with the investigation team.
I am going to ask Mr. Katavazi, together with all the witnesses, the ones from Kisoro, Kanungu, Rukunjiri, the ones who came here, to go to the CID to make statements.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.